All right, so a long time ago, back in 2009 or so, I played this game as the very first video game I ever uploaded to YouTube. Secret Mana, originally for the Super Nintendo, is by far one of the best RPGs ever made, and I think is one of the very few RPGs to have multiplayer built into its game, like co-op. Cooperative play in an RPG is quite rare. It is a fantastic game on the Super Nintendo. On like the remake, I'm not 100% sure yet, but I'm gonna play it because this is really one of my favorite games of all time, and it's a game I always recommend to people. So I'm gonna do a little playthrough of a game that I have high expectations of because I love this game, and I think if Square understood how much people like this game, they would have made a really good job of a remake. I've played a little bit to try and get like the settings and stuff, into play. Now, I messed around with the audio earlier. I hate the remake music, and if you've played the original before, you may understand why I dislike the remake when you get to hear it just a little bit, but I left the original on for the introduction to kind of get a feel for it. The 16-bit music is actually way better in some regards, if not all regards, in this game. It's actually kind of crazy. I don't know what Square were really thinking with it. Anyway, I'm gonna start a new game here. As you can see, I played a little bit, like 3 minutes worth of the game, just to kind of get used to the controls and my controller and stuff like that, because it's not a Super Nintendo controller, it's an Xbox 360 wire controller for PC. I'm playing this on Steam, and I'm just gonna start the game here. Now, this might be something I come to regret later, but I'm gonna have the audio language set on English. From what little I have heard, I don't like the voice acting, and when bad voice acting is hidden behind a language you can't understand, it's a bit more tolerable. But for the sheer experience of experiencing a remake the way that it's meant to be experienced in the country that I live in, I'm gonna play it in English and obviously read in English. And I'm gonna leave the boy's name as Randy because that's actually his name. In the original, it wasn't pre-filled, kind of like in The Legend of Zelda games, where it's not pre-filled to be Link, apart from the newer ones. I think Twilight Princess Onwards did pre-filling of Link. However, Randy is his default name, and we're gonna leave it that way. It's like the Final Fantasy X effect, where if you don't actually say like the main character's name, like in Final Fantasy X, we wouldn't say Tidus aloud.
Long ago, the world prospered and humanity thrived thanks to a power known as mana. However, humans soon sought to use mana to create the ultimate weapon, a floating battleship called the Mana Fortress. This greedy arrogance angered the gods, who in turn unleashed vicious beasts into the world. A violent war between the mana beasts and the fortress engulfed the world in poison and fire until mana had all but disappeared. In humanity's bleakest hour, a hero wielding the mana sword appeared and destroyed the fortress. The world was left in shambles, and yet humanity persevered, and there was peace throughout the land. But as time passes, so history repeats.
So that dialogue sequence is actually quite different to the original. I mean, it's just paraphrased differently. It's worded differently, but it's not completely telling a different story.
Hey! Guys! Wait up!
And in the original, there'll be music playing here.
Be quiet, stupid. If the Elder finds us here, we're done for.
But there isn't in the
Yeah.
remake.
We're not supposed to be here. Everyone in the village knows about the ghost.
You really believe that old fib? The grown-ups just say there's a ghost to scare us away. But I did hear Grandma say she saw something shiny by the falls when she was little.
Maybe it's treasure. Let's go find it.
Help! I'm gonna fall!
See, that whole sequence is a little bit different. It's not significant in any regard. But the music that kicks in after this plane is meant to play when they're up there.
There's no way back up. Now what am I gonna do?
So, already, if you're used to the original, the music here is different and you might be kind of put off by it. For me, I'm a little bit put off by it, but I'll deal with it for the next 5 minutes or so. Dashing is done by A, but we don't have the percentage meter quite yet. The percentage meter hasn't been displayed, so I can't actually tell how far I can run.
What's the sword doing here? Too bright! What's with this light? Oh, ghost!
Listen. I entrust the sword to you.
Huh? What do you mean? What's up with this sword? The light's fading already. Oh, I have to get back to the village!
So, like, fun fact for those of you that played the original. The original is basically more or less programmed by one guy, or the reputation is that he did the majority of the programming. So, one guy basically coded the entire original game. It's kind of nuts when you think about it. His name is Nasir Gabelli, and in the original there was like a way to bring up his initials in the status bar. Well, NES, not his initials. And he coded a lot of the really old Square Enix like RPG games like Final Fantasy for the Super Nintendo and the NES games and stuff like that. He's really renowned, and with him not being around anymore, he doesn't make video games anymore. In fact, I don't think he does anything, he just kind of lives off of royalties. He doesn't really have any input in this game anymore, so when he remade it without him, I'm like skeptical that they wouldn't keep all the fine details that he implemented into the game. However, it seems for the most part that the game's still decent. I think it's still Secret of Mana, it just lacks a few things from the, like, 14 minutes that I've played, but, like, that doesn't necessarily scream a bad flag, a red flag to me at all. I think that the game so far is fun to the point where I will continue to play it, but I also think that some of the adjustments that they've made is fine so far. So this song here doesn't sound as bad as the song that I was playing beforehand. I didn't mean to read that same, by the way. In the remake, there's some music in this remake that, like, it sounds okay, but I still much prefer the original. So we're gonna get a level up here soon. It hasn't quite happened yet, but it should happen before we get to the village, if it's anything like the original. I can actually do a strike attack now. I didn't even realize it went up an attack level. But this little charge bar, in the original it had a glitch where you could overflow it when you had more than one party member. I really doubt that's in this anymore because it legitimately is a bug. But it's interesting when I'm doing the charge here. Is that this meter doesn't have a number representation to it anymore until it actually meets the level. So the little gray space, the empty space at the edge of the meter, used to be a representation of the number. So 0 and 1 or whatever would be there. Oh, the movement is still really slow when you've got a full charge. That's interesting. And also, when we came down here with the rabbits, there was 4 of them, I think. In the original, there's only 3 most of the time because the game can't render 4 at once. It's interesting that they fixed that, or they knew about it from the original game. So they must have had some deeper insight into the code than the average developer would. Most developers would analyze it by playing, not by looking at the actual in-game code to see how many were rendered at once. This is actually really interesting. The outline when you go behind the building, I think that's good. It's a good way of trying to hide it, or hide for the fact that it doesn't have a dynamic camera or shift, and it doesn't make the houses transparent. They thought it would be a better idea to do the outline of the characters, and I think it's a good way of approaching it. It's actually really unique. I haven't seen that before. Before, in the beta, these shopkeepers didn't dance. In the pre-release stuff that it was showing, the shopkeepers didn't dance, and it had a lot of people off-put. They were really mad over it. I personally was pretty upset that they didn't dance and stuff, but they do now, thankfully. So it is a lot closer to the original, and that's one thing that I had a problem with appeased. Now, the minimap at the top right is basically the Super Nintendo game. It does look a little bit different, actually, just like visually, but I think it's because it's zoomed out a little bit too much from the detail of the sprites, so like the flowers and the edges of the house, the pixelation looks a bit different, but it more or less looks the same. I think this was a kid before, or maybe it was a guy, I don't know. Anyway, we're just gonna go up here and progress. So I've played this game before. I know pretty much everything what I'm gonna do, unless we've changed anything.
That's why I told you not to bring someone like him along.
You idiots! None of you were supposed to wander into that area. What's that you have there? Oh no! It couldn't be.
Cool. Did you find the treasure?
Way to go!
What have you done? That's the mana sword. There's no way you could have pulled it free.
Mana sword? But legend says the village will be destroyed if it's removed.
I never thought it'd come to this. The mana sword is sent to protect the village from disaster. But...
Aha! So you're the reason all those monsters are attacking us.
Alright, the music is actually starting to drive me nuts. I'm gonna change it to the classic after this. They added rumble to Elliot hitting you, which is interesting.
It's all your fault. Leave me alone.
Alright, okay, that kind of annoys me. His walking animation sucks still. And Gemma just came through the door. I don't think it opened, but I wasn't completely paying attention. Oh my god, the boss music is terrible. Alright, okay. This is actually the best representation of the music I can give here. I think, anyway, because the boss music means so much to so many people. Listen to it right now. Now listen to this. What one would you rather play with? It's so obvious. Anyway. Is the sickle gonna... Yeah, it homes in still. Okay, so in the beta, it didn't home in, and it just kind of disappeared, and everybody was confused when it happened. So that's interesting, but, like, the beta has changed, you know, to the final build, but he actually went back and he fixed Mantis a little bit. Alright, so Mantis actually has a drop shadow to him, like a shadow effect going on, so you can see where he is, unlike the original. However, magic still seems to have an infinite radius, so that's still kind of broken, like the original. Yeah, it has an infinite radius. So no matter what, you're still gonna take a little bit of a beating here. Now, using items is actually pointless in this battle, because Gemma revives you. Yeah, it still holds in regardless, so there's nothing I can do about it. I think I'm gonna die here, but you're gonna see what happens. No, never mind, he's dead. So, there's also Steam in-game achievements, but they won't show up in the video because I have the HUD hidden. But I'm going to be leaving the classic music on from now on. That was enough for me to know which way I want to play this game. I wanted to experience the remake, but they destroyed possibly my favorite track in the game, which is the boss battle theme.
Wait there, I'll pull you up.
And it was just really painful to listen to for the most part.
Stay back. I didn't do nothing.
I'm really glad that they put the option to have the original OST in here though, or I'd be really upset when playing the entire game.
Of the real mana sword. This is troubling.
Why is that?
The legend says the sword can only be retrieved by a knight when the world is in peril. But you are far too young for such a responsibility. Something must be wrong with the mana sword.
Here, you take it.
No, I cannot. The sword has lost its power. It must be restored. Only the one who pulled it free can do that.
Then, what should I do?
Visit Sage Luca in the Water Palace. The sage has protected these lands for over 200 years. You would do well to listen to her advice.
Hey! The Elder wants you to come to his house.
I'll be off. I have duties to attend. My name is Gemma, and I'll be waiting for you at the Water Palace.
So, the mouth flaps being non-existent are something I really don't like so far. I kinda wish they had mouth flaps, even if it was very minor.
We can't ignore them!
We're at our wit's end! Who knows when another monster will appear?
Oh, it's you.
The BGM is too high, I think.
Has protected us for years.
Like the background music? But I'm using the default setting, so I don't know what's up with that. It's like too high over the characters talking.
It's settled. We can't let him stay in the village anymore. He'll just bring more monsters.
But maybe that's a good thing with some of the voice acting.
Go!
Get out of here!
Yeah! Leave here now!
What are these star animations? Like, it's weird in the original, but it's not that apparent.
I don't want to do this, but there's a treasure chest downstairs. Take the contents and be on your way.
Alright, so I'm gonna fix this real fast. Where's the BGM? So lower that to like 50, maybe? If I could actually land on 50. And see if that, like, fixes their little issue here. I think, hold on, what does she actually say? Because, and I think she says, like, heading out, see ya, or something?
Are you going somewhere? See you later.
Well, they changed her dialogue. I'd be interested to see what Nasir actually thinks of a remake. Like, he made the original, more or less, so I'd be interested to see what he thinks one day. He probably doesn't care.
You need?
Yeah, I do. I don't need anything from here.
By order of the Elder, you have been banished from Poto's village. Now be gone!
Yeah, some of the voice acting is not the finest stuff in the world, but, I mean, it's nice that it's there, I guess. If it was just text, I'm sure a lot of younger audiences would be put off because they don't like reading. Anyway, we're gonna go down here. So the percentage meter actually ticks down when you run and not up, which is really odd. This flower enemy is not how I pictured it ever looking either. But sure enough, that's how they drew it, I guess. See, it like ticks down, so I can run from for the 100%, I guess. It goes back up after I let go. The mushroom, more or less, looks like what I thought he would. I mean, to be honest, it's just kind of a rendered representation of what he looked like before. I wish the ding was a little bit noticeable. So in the original, your character flashes when you get back to 100%, and that doesn't happen here. And that representation is actually kind of annoying me for the most part, because I can't effectively do 100% slashes without looking down at the percentage meter. But by doing that, you're taking your eyes off of the combat, and that's not what you want to be doing. And you also don't want to listen to the audio cue, because there's so much going on most of the time, but it's like difficult to guarantee that you're even listening to the right audio cue. Or at least that's my interpretation of it. I think I'm right with it, but if anybody wants to prove me wrong, if they're an audio engineer, then feel free. So dialogue looks really different.
Has sent us to fight Elena, the witch who lives in the haunted forest.
That's an interesting way to pronounce her name. I would have called her Elaine, or
there's a shortcut warp that leads something to the witch, but you need a whip to cross this chasm.
I think you thought so.
That's
this
our
one.
Leader, Major Dylan. He's young, but no one doubts his skill. He knows how dangerous this mission is, but I've never seen the Major.
Alright, normally the
Major Dylan, sir.
Alright, okay.
Set.
Understood. Stay focused, men. Let's move out.
So they'll all go over here. And go through this like warp area, and this warp area leads to the haunted forest, but we're not gonna go there until later. So I'm gonna go through the War Palace here and go talk to Luca like Gemma wants me to. And bear in mind, this is like my first time ever seeing most of this area in 3D. All the demo stuff doesn't really show you this area, so it's interesting to see. I think it looks more or less identical to how I pictured it would look in 3D.
Uh-oh, where's Luca? I guess I'll ask that girl over there. Hey, where do I find Luca?
They changed the soul composition already.
It's nice to see you again, Sage.
You're very welcome.
Wait, you mean this little girl is 200 years old?
Oh, so you're the one who found the mana sword. Fascinating.
Luca, monsters have started invading villages. This young boy just fought one himself.
You underestimate my intelligence. World news flows into this palace with the water's own currents. Mana grows ever weaker. That could explain how this child was able to take the sword from its place of rest. His actions caused the balance of mana in this area to shift. Beasts are now rampaging across the land again. Evil in the world is working to seal away the power of the mana sword forever. By defeating monsters and obtaining their orbs, you can reforge and restore the sword's mana power. It looks like your sword regained some power from vanquishing the mantis ant. There are more hidden orbs with the mana power to revive the sword. You must find them.
Okay, so she'll let me recharge it here, I think.
Eye on the Empire. It seeks the mana fortress's power.
Fortress? Like the one that destroys the world in that fairy tale?
This is no fairy tale. We're talking about the real Mana Fortress, and the Empire that wants its power.
The Empire will try to break the seals on the Mana Seeds in each palace. I've already caught some Empire spies snooping around my own palace.
There are strange reports coming in from Pandora. Could the Empire be involved?
I do not know. Gemma, you should request an audience with the King and tell him to be wary of the Empire.
Understood. I'll leave now. Head for the cave in Gaia's navel. There's a dwarf blacksmith that lives in the area. Dwarves are known for their weapon-making skills. You should see if they can reforge the sword. As the sword becomes more powerful, your skills will improve, and you'll learn more abilities.
What frightens you so?
I think both lead to the same conversation.
The legendary mana sword, but its power has faded. Now it's hardly better than a normal weapon. It used the last of its power to choose a new master.
But why did it pick me?
I don't have that answer. But you drew the sword, and now it's your responsibility.
So where do I fit in?
You must become a hero who is worthy of the sword. Come, hold the sword up to the seed on the altar.
Okay, so now we get to recharge the sword and get out of here, hopefully. This part of the game always takes quite some time. I'm not sure if Luca will allow us to save the game.
What happened?
The seed and the sword have now synchronized with each other. Now no matter where you are in the world, this mana seed, you found one of the 8 palaces. Now you must visit the others and obtain the powers of their seeds. I worry about you out in the world with only a rusted sword. Take this spear I imbued with holy water.
Okay, so we got the spear as well, and we'll be using that shortly.
And it too will regain its true power. I'll heal you. Would you like to save the game?
And now we'll save. I'm gonna save over this file here.
Take Gemma's advice and head to Gaia's Navel. There you can find the underground palace. To reach Gaia's Navel, head south through the Kingdom of Pandora.
Okay, cool. So I'm gonna wrap up the first part here real fast in this little menu. And I want to say so far the game is pretty good, in terms of like just actually playing it. Obviously I will, I think from now on, be playing with the original soundtrack. I highly recommend that you do as well if you own the game. The soundtrack is regarded as one of the best soundtracks in video games, and is like one of the best, if not the best soundtrack on the Super Nintendo. And I highly recommend listening to it in its normal manner, and not that remake that destroyed the boss theme, in my opinion. Anyway, yeah, so far it's pretty decent. I'm gonna record a little bit more tonight. I'm sorry for the snuffly, like, voice work. I'm kinda sick at the moment, but I'm dealing with it. I just wanted to play the game, and I felt like this was something that I should record, because it is more of a first impression sort of thing of a game that I played a lot when I was a kid, and is one of my favorite games of all time. Anyway, thanks for watching, and see you guys in the next part of Secret Mana. I kind of want to call it HD, but really it's just called Secret Mana. Anyway, see you next time.